This is a very nice looking. Whoa. Marx Toys Car of the Future Recast or Copy. Inspecting the bottom. See where that circle is there? Underneath the axle. That should have the Marx logo, as this example demonstrates here. There it is. And this example demonstrates here. It's definitely a Marx design.
Ash, can you see this?
Awesome lines to it. I mean, it can be whatever it wants. And because it's got the open cab, an astronaut or two could conceivably be seated in there, off doing some sort of space task or whatever. And what I'm hoping, actually, quietly, is that those wheel axles might fit on this original. Although I'm not going to mess with it now. Let's do a little insert, because I'd forgotten that an attribute by which to differentiate the original cars from the recasts is on the original Cars of the Future, the wheels are mounted on the outside of the axle brace. And on the recasts, the wheels are on the inside of the brace with that little notch there, keeping it in place. And the purist in me says, you know what, let's ixnay that idea of trying to swamp them and just hope that an original set of axles crosses my radar at some point and keep everything just the way it is. Look at those tail sections, just gorgeous. All right, let's get back to it. And for the amount of money that I didn't pay for it, it was a good deal. It could have, even as a copy, this is nice. Copy is probably the wrong word, too. It's a recast. It's a reissue. Color. The gold color is different, although they varied their mixes for this series. Doesn't have the same sharp clink as the other two. But look at those lines. That's a clean machine. That's the machine of a dream. And it doesn't matter for the amount of money. It can be a recast, and I'm still delighted. Many thanks to the vendor. And like I said, I hadn't expected to take it. I did. I got out my other Marx vehicles. Oh yeah, let's compare these to the Archer car, World of Tomorrow car place. I think that's what it's called. And definitely some different design sensibilities. This is a simpler design than the Marx vehicles. Here's our Archer stamp there with the 1952 date. They're probably all about the same age. Except this. Who knows? You know, it's a mute plastic object at this point. I'd hope it was from 1990 or earlier. Who knows? No way to know. No way to tell. If someone knows how to tell, give us a shout. But I thought I'd compare it to the Archer car. And, you know, they all rock. And for uses photo subjects and art pieces, you can't miss it. I got out my other Marx vehicles too, and yeah, I opened this one up back, I don't know, November or October, and it turns out it's one of the forklift vehicles
from the Marx American Airlines International Jetport set, or one of the follow-up sets from it, made 1960 to 1963.
These two here, these are ground transport vehicles that were probably used in any number of sets, and I think they came from a Cape Canaveral playset in the Motherlode lot from back in August, and each would have a trailer connected to it here. They did not survive the sands of time, and at some point I should probably try to find trailers for them. There's no markings on them, but they're definitely Marx originals. Here's the neon green car that we picked up the other week, and the coupe next to it. And I did some more nosing around and figured out there's a little Marx tank, hard plastic. The thing is absolutely gorgeous and adorable. There's our logo there. Its size is explained now by being a railway car
load made for a toy train set as a cargo.
I think that's why it's of the size that it is.
It may also have been included in military vehicle sets of the same scale, but I'm pretty sure it's meant to ride on a train.
I could be wrong, but I know that I found a couple of sales listings for Marx railway cars that had similar looking tanks on them. I was like, oh, okay, that's why it's kind of a dinky little diminutive size there, as opposed to the put it next to it. And yeah, that's sort of a down, even compared to the Ford coupe, it's a downsizer. That might be about the same size there. And I could get a trailer for the truck, and it could haul that around, and we'll have all sorts of fun in space, right? Picked up a bag full of these over the summer. Turns out they're by Empire Plastic. This is my favorite of them because it's in a soft plastic. And here, of course, Mattel Dreammobile, which will survive my ownership of it. And someday pass on to a lucky collector, along with my Marx vehicles. Fun stuff. Fun in space. That's what we're after here. And that's a beauty. The machine of a dream. Such a clean machine.